And I think Quickshot made a really solid point there. We know Rainover works well with his top laner Huni. We know Fnatic's bot lane is good at playing passive. Let's not call them passive, but they're good at playing passive. Everything leads into the direction of, if the normal lanes come out, of Fnatic trying to shut down Steve, because it has proven to be efficient, at least at the start. Last week he was on Maokai. Maybe Fnatic says, okay, Steve, you're not playing Maokai this week. We don't want to give you the chance to come back into the game by playing this very straightforward tank-heavy champion. But instead of theorizing, let's just look at the bans. Lu banned out, Alistar banned out by Fnatic, so they want to get another first pick in here, potentially the Maokai, because Rocket, as every other team, is throwing a lot of bans towards Huni.
Mm-hmm. Okay, they start that one off with the Hecarim ban. They'll also throw a Rek'Sai one
out. So many bans for Rek'Sai. Every game.
There have been a ton.
Ton of bans on the Rek'Sai. And Gragas.
Not a good day for Xur'Sai.
No. Potential first pick Gragas here for Fnatic. Alistar is out of the support. Morgana's been doing well, but I think there's correlation and causation, and I think it's more fortunate that Morgana's 5-0. I don't think she's necessarily there for first pick warded. I think a lot of her value comes in counterpicking and fitting into situations where Black Shield is really, really useful. But I could be wrong. Obviously, I have been wrong before many, many times. Kalista coming out. Tough lane matchup for a lot of AD carries. And I wonder, is Fnatic going to go for a third Ashe in a row? Because then Reckless will be falling into a pattern.
Mm-hmm. Well, they first picked it in their first game, and then, of course, it was still valued enough in the next. And Rocket spend their last ban on Rumble, another Huni ban.
If you believe that Rek'Sai is also a top laner, which over in China
three
people
Huni
do,
bans,
then you have three Huni bans.
Yeah. And there's the man himself.
Okay, first pick.
That's a possibility. He's only played Gnar so far in the opening week, but...
And he does well into the Maokai matchup as well. So I've said this before, Huni can play Gnar into Maokai and Maokai into Gnar, but the question is, can Steve play Gnar into Maokai?
We might get a chance to put that to the test.
If he can't, then I'm okay.
Oh, okay, that's different. We got
Rise. He got changed on 5.10 and has allegedly became very, very strong. So, interesting. To first pick that, that's...
I mean, that sends a message right there. We'll see what Rocket answer with. They've got 45 seconds to do it.
Now, the ecosystem off top lane has severely been damaged because Hecarim is out, Rek'Sai to an extent, not the most common top laner, but Rumble as well is out, so there's less matchups prevalent to counter pick that with. And Ryze punishes people that have to aggress on you because then it makes it easier for him to land a skill shot. So he could do well into Maokai. Actually, I've never seen the matchup, so I'm just guessing right here. But he does cast a lot of spells, giving Maokai a lot of sustain. But a ranged champion with repetitive damage could prove useful to punish a Maokai.
Yeah, we'll have to wait to see if that's the matchup we do get. For now, Rocket are going to take their chances with the Urgot, with the Gragas, two picks that fell through the ban phase that we have noted earlier in the show. It was a very, very valuable choices.
Market value of Sivir has just gone through the roof. You don't necessarily want to play Ashe into Urgot, because if you ever get slowed, you can get swapped at insta-burst. However, Ashe is very potent at keeping a range, so you could argue that it's a skill matchup, but I just like Sivir so much, especially adding mobility to that Ryze in the backline to move around or potentially get him, help him close the distance to the carries he needs to one-shot. Definitely, we'll see later. I think Fnatic's gonna build a couple more stones, lay the foundation for the composition, and see what fits.
Now, one thing that should definitely fit is that Nautilus, but really curious to see what they do decide to go with in the mid. It seems to be what they're trying to lock in right about now.
I think support mid is a good rotation, or a good pick duo on the second rotation on blue side, because you will have to counter pick your mid lane anyways. Any team worth their salt will counter pick your mid lane on the fifth pick on purple side anyways, so why don't you just pick it here already? Support is generic. You can support just means what you want to do with it, so it doesn't necessarily get counter picked all too much. Good adaptation from Fnatic here, and they can choose to go for the Ashe later or for the Sivir if it proves that Ashe is very likely to get dove on and wombo comboed by the likes of the Maokai coming in with the Black Shield, Gragas going in, Urgot trying to shut her down. So we might see a Sivir pick here for Fnatic.
Yeah, it's looking to be a hell of a front line for Rocket right now. We'll see if they decide to change their mind and go with the Gnar pickup for Steve. Vander looking to take the Morgana. They've got plenty of time on the clock, but let's go back to Fnatic for just a second, because that Azir pickup for Febiven. It's a lot of magic damage. You combine that up with Ryze.
A lot of magic damage, but Reckless has proven that he can be a one-man AD carry to provide that damage, so I wouldn't worry too much about that. Steve's not sure. He wants the Maokai, but I think he's afraid of the matchup to see how it plays out. And they kind of want a tank too, and not a conditional tank like Gnar. Yes, he's tanky, but you want him in Mega form. And even then, if he jumps in, hops in, Ryze has a snare to shut him down. You have the Azir Empress Divide coming in as well to shut that down, and Vayne Hover. That's interesting. Well, if you want 80 carry damage in the late game,
yep,
Andrew damage, and a lot of hops, tumbles.
Doesn't matter how many tanks you play into in that case. Let's see if they go for that. So they're thinking about it. Reckless has prized the Ash, as we've said last week, but you know, we're on a new patch.
Not so sure about
a new week.
Not so sure about Nautilus Vayne as a lane though.
Yeah.
Incredibly tricky to play into Urgot Morgana.
I mean, if there's a duo that can do it though, Reckless and Yellowstar.
Well, there's a lot of other potent lanes or laners in the European LCS. Miffy and Neil spring to mind, but they'll definitely be good at playing passive enough to get through the laning phase without giving them too many kills. But the CS deficit is what worries me. I don't think they're gonna go for this Vayne.
No, they don't have to pick it at all. Instead, they lock in the Ezreal, and we get to see ourselves another Evelynn. Well, the enemy might not see it, but...
Well, at one point they will. It's just a matter of what they see once she engages. Rek'Sai, Gragas out, Evelynn pick up. It's becoming quite a trend in Europe. People used to go for the Sejuani in the pick, but ever since the Clear Love Nation attack, it kind of became Evelynn as a third in the row in succession. Rocket, they wanted to kind of pick the mid lane.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe they already have with Morgana, I doubt it. Morgana into Azir doesn't sound like a fun matchup to play at all. And quite good on support here. What is Nuketuck going to bring out of that? Is he going to play passive? Because Febiven sounds like a player to me that can punish the fact that Nuketuck's very passive in his early game. Not necessarily through kills on the map, but he can roam left and right because Fnatic plays incredibly well as a team and...
What?
Irelia!
We've seen this before, Crepo, but not with Nuketuck.
It takes a fantastic player to pull off Irelia mid. Faker did it first. Moved heaven on earth.
They're
is Nuketuck
going to
do it?
In. Let's see if they can pull that off. I think the stakes just got a little higher here, Crepo.
Yeah, definitely interesting. I like it that Rocket's trying something new because Fnatic as a team seems to outclass everybody else in European LCS, bar maybe Origin so far. We haven't seen that matchup. We will see it, I believe, in week 4. So throwing a bit of a curveball, that's proven to work. Could be just a thing they need.
Yeah. Maybe let's see if Rocket can maybe channel their inner unicorns. Remember, last split, that gave Fnatic a run for their money a lot of the times around, but we've got our compositions locked in, and oh boy, this looks like an interesting match.
Lot of dive, and not so much siege potential. When the highest range champion on your team, barring support, is an Urgot, you're not going to siege all too much.
No, I think that's definitely a fair statement. Let's take a look at how we expect this early game to go, because once again, just like last game, we're going to think a lot about this mid lane, but I don't think that's where it's going to start. I'm really curious to see how this bottom line goes, but it's not about what I think. It's about what you guys think. Why don't you tell us at LOL Esports, FNC win or ROC win? We've got ourselves a matchup on our hands as Fnatic and Team Rocket take to the Rift. Here we go.
And I like that Fevin's bringing out the cleanse because if I recall correctly, Faker maxed E in the matchup, didn't point any points in W because Irelia in the mid lane isn't going to be that repetitive auto attacker, so he will go E max for it to prolong stuns, get a few hits in, then dash out with the Q or do the Q for another possible Sheen proc. So that will definitely happen, but Nuketuck is prepared. He wants to cleanse that stun. He doesn't want to get stunned for 2 seconds in that mid lane later in the game. And Fnatic there, bunching up and poising to move into the enemy jungle. Said this before, usually not a fan because you trade vision, but Jankos is sleeping.
Oh, yes. He's going to get bonked for just a second now. Yellowstar and the rest of Fnatic are chasing him on. They grab him. He's going to flash. Exhaust was on him as well. At the end of the day, a summoner for summoner, but that is not how you want to start out as a jungler.
Now, this is what usually happens once you go for a 4 or 5 man invade, is that the enemy team will enter your jungle, play some wards that you have no idea where they are, but ironically, they tend to be quite predictable. So both teams with a mirror on lane swap wards, as we call it. That little ward that Vander is about to place is called the lane swap ward because you want to see if the enemy bot lane or top laner happens to pass that. So I will see actually an adaptation soon that people will start avoiding that place. And you can basically fake it out by not placing the ward and just placing it somewhere else. But those are all mind games for level ones. A little bit too in-depth to go into right now. Poison Wanted Golems. When a lane swap is likely, when it's unsure and people want to lane swap, they usually move to the top lane so you can steal their golems and basically steal the camp of the enemy. And worst case, you spot them at the golem. So I like this offensive positioning from Rocket because in a 2v2, they have a decent lane early, especially if you can punish these golems.
Yeah, they might be able to do it. Give Reckless and Yellowstar a bit of a hard time to start this one off. They're going for the mini Krugs. Reckless is in some trouble here, though. He's forced to use Summoner Heal right away. That's going to be a very quick back here. And meanwhile, Nuketuck's not wasting any time on Febiven.
Yeah, waits for a couple of creeps to go low, dashes to one, gets the reset, dashes to another, gets the reset, and then jumps on Febiven. And only level one with a soldier. Febiven can't stop that aggression. Nuketuck going for the flask, just like Faker did. And Rocket held on, Rocket Vander rather, held on to his ignite. A lot of pressure coming out, and I like the patience. Don't go for the bind too early, because they have no idea where you are. The golems didn't get long-range pulled, so they didn't have a chance to aggro towards that brush. So Rocket, they were hiding for ages. They could have even waited any longer, but they went for the secure bind on Reckless. He had to use his heal. He's now behind in the lane, and Rocket starting out this game well.
Exactly, and you know, with the way we know Yellowstar and Reckless like to play together and like to be you know, safe, especially with this lane, this Ezreal Nautilus lane, it could be really, really hard for them to try and make something happen. They might be calling for some help, but Rainover, you know, is he going to be able to give that to them, provide that support in the early game?
And remember, Evelynn goes extremely low on first clear, so I doubt it. The wave will automatically push towards Fnatic's side, so I think they will just have to suck it up and take the CS lead and just deal with it somehow. Early XP on Urgot is fantastic because level 1, you can contest him a little bit, but once he gets level 3, if he lands that Noxian Corrosion Charge and can connect the Qs on top of Reckless maybe once or twice, he will get poked out of the lane. He's down to heal is ready. Ignite can be the difference between life or death, and they'll definitely have to be very careful, and a lot of stress will be on Vander's side. He has to land those bindings.
Yeah, he's got to be able to make those count. He was able to connect that one early on that forced Reckless back and pretty much established this lane lead for them. Meanwhile, though, speaking of lane lead, Huni is punishing Steve. I think that's fairly to be expected. Steve is a much more untested entity in this top side, but really what's also untested is this new Ryze.
Now, you see Jankos poising in that top lane to prevent the possibility. Yes, Evelynn goes low very early, but is likely to show up top first because history has proven that people like the gang Steve. Huni is very immobile, so even if Jankos doesn't show up, Huni might have to flash.
Yep, there's two flashes right there, and Jankos comes right on in with the barrel. Huni's in some trouble. It's unfamiliar territory for him. Is giving up first blood. Oh, there comes Stopling! Oh, boy.
I really like that play. They didn't both flash at the same time. They waited for Steve to do flash twisted advance. Even if Huni flashes, he will follow him. This prompts the body slam flash from Jankos. They can chase. Red buff slows him down and left for field goal, for touchdown sapling rather. And beautiful guy by Rocket, and they're going back in history and changing it, because now Steve isn't the first one to fall, the first one to get a kill. And
yeah,
but for Steve,
good start for him on this Maokai here. That'll help him out quite a bit. So tables get a little bit turned for these two top laners, Febiven and Rainover, now in the middle together, but it's not known by Nuketuck just yet. Meanwhile, Reckless still having some serious trouble. So Fnatic really not off to the greatest of starts for themselves, but Nuketuck could be in some trouble. Rainover shows face. Febiven dashes forward. Nuketuck saves.
And you'll notice that whenever Nuketuck goes in, he has a low HP creep in the back as his escape tool. That's what he does every time so far. He leaves that one creep on low HP, goes for a bit of a trade, and then has that to dash out potentially. And then that means Rainover, without Harsh CC, can't really lock Aurelia down. So it's very hard for him to find a gank, and he's looking for Steve, but Jankos is ready with the counter gank, and no flash on Huni.
Yeah, and it's a little bit too late here for Rainover. Huni, again, he could go down. Shields on him for just a second, but Jankos still picks him up. Rainover now looking to avenge his fallen comrade as Jankos goes back in, throws the barrel. Rainover is going down. That's Steve with a 2-0 start on this Maokai, and double buffs.
Double kill for Rocket, 3-0 in the lead. 2,000 gold ahead, and Fnatic, well, we said last week, they played passive, they played slow, and they could have gotten punished, and they're definitely getting punished now. Beautiful execution from Rocket, and I like the return gank from Jankos. We said before, ganks are usually a two-step process. You take their flash, and then you kill them. But what if you take their flash and kill them? Well, then you simply go kill them again, especially on Ryze, and this is why Ryze had fallen out of the meta. Incredibly immobile, really hard to play against a lot of these top laners, and Maokai doesn't have enough damage to take him off on his own, but with the help of Jankos, plenty of damage.
Not only that, you know, Huni can't really return fire for all that much. That build that he's going, you know, yes, he scales off that mana, but he's not got that many stacks on his tier, partially because he's spending so much time dead now.
Yeah, that's a good point, Pyro, because if you look back, how does a Ryze build? If you have forgotten that, it's the same every game. He goes tier, Catalyst, Rod of Ages, into Seraph's Embrace. A lot of mana that translates into a lot of damage, but if you can slow that down, buying an extra minute, slowing down the Rod of Ages, slows him down even more exponentially, so to say, because he has to scale with that, and he's incredibly weak in the mid game, and you can keep punishing him over and over again. That's exactly what Rocket looks to be doing.
Be careful, Rainover coming around the side. There's a pink ward. Nankos! There's a teleport now coming in for Steve. Febavin and Rainover might have been baited here as Dukta comes around the line. In comes Huni as well. Emperor's Divide to push
they
Steve
turn
back,
around.
But they can start the turn around if they need to. Nuketuck is the one they're focusing down, but battered and bruised, him and Steve. Well, Steve is running actually in right now, and Febavin's going down. Steve picks it up yet again, but he's shut down by Huni, who gets some much-needed gold back as Nuketuck gets slain by Yellowstar. Coming up from the bottom side, the fight continues as Yankos looking for Huni and Rainover, but now looking just to get out safe. He's got a flash on him, but in comes the Urgot.
Wolite's
looking
coming
to finish this one up. He's flashing forward, and he's gonna find Rainover. Vander still on the chase with Yellowstar. All said and done, though, quite a lot back and forth, but Rocket comes out ahead.
A bold turnaround by Rocket, but somehow this fight comes out relatively even. I believe Febavin even fail flashed a bit in that fight, leading to Rocket to a kill, but I think they should have just backed out because Reckless wasn't in that fight. He's pushing in bot lane, he's taking farm, he's slowly getting into that game. Top lane was pushed in, so Steve lost a bit of farm. Looking to pick up that wave right now, though. So I think this, all in all, this turned out pretty okay for Fnatic, especially considering the fact that Steve was the one that teleported in. Imagine if they just disengaged, had Steve snowball his advantage 1v1 in the top lane and kept that repetition going. Why go for a group fight if you can just keep punishing the slow one? Let's look at that again. Jankos gets caught. Doesn't get ulti. He's fine. They can drop the fight right here, but Steve comes in all of a sudden. He goes in. Doesn't know who to go in, and Huni speeds up with the shrine, comes in, and Steve gets punished. Now Nuketuck will get snared right now. And yeah, they have to run because there's a lot of this ranged poke damage. This is good. Re-engage kind of catches Febavin off guard. Unlucky fail flash, or unlucky, arguably maybe just a bad flash overall. Rainover will eventually drop later in this fight, but Nuketuck goes down. And this is just getting Huni back in the game, and this is speeding his catalyst up, and that's exactly what we said earlier. You don't want to do that. But I think Rocket overreach here, remembering especially that they invested a teleport into this play, and Huni simply walked down. They could have been a teleport ahead, kept that 2,000 gold advantage, instead of like making it smaller, and now they're going for a dragon though.
Yep, the only one there to try and contest this is Yellowstar, but the rest of Fnatic are coming in. There's actually a teleport in from Huni, but Dragon is already down, so he cancels it. Oh, mistiming.
He maybe saw that the ward was about to go down, Dragon was about to go down, and he went on his gut feeling, but then he looked at his minimap and he saw Rainover not even close there. Dragon was already down, teleport canceled. Wonder if Rocket saw this. They have no idea whether this happened or not, obviously, so they might play under the information that he still has teleport and respect it. Yeah, Fnatic, last week, calm, secure, control. This week, not quite so.
No, they seem to be very flustered. You take a look at that stat with the two Dragon averages. Rockets usually want to take one a lot later, and Fnatic, well, they're the ones who couldn't contest this time around. Meanwhile, though, Steve is getting chunked out by Huni, who's finally gotten rolling, and he's stunned up after the flash. Huni follows him through and solos him down.
Huni, Huni, Huni. What the hell just happened? How does he do that? Steve should have been so far ahead in this matchup. This should not be allowed to happen. He went for extra damage. He skipped the catalyst, might go straight into R changes, or just picked up the damage component first in that blasting wand. And I think we just found out why Fnatic first picked that Ryze. That was a lot of damage.
Yeah, took a little while to go rolling, but once it did, I don't think Steve knew what hit him there. Rainover gonna find himself a pink ward, collect on that gold all the way to the bank. And now Nuketuck knows he can't jump willy-nilly onto Febavin.
And this is the mark of great teams, that immediately when a champion gets changed, they're not afraid to try it out in the LCS. Have some experimentation, recognize when a champion is strong, and get ahead of their opponents. Fnatic is one step ahead with this Ryze contest, with this Ryze pick, because if teams eventually catch on next week, say Ryze is actually really, really strong, then Fnatic already knows how to play him, perhaps knows how to counter him, and they're ahead of the curve. If it works out, we'll still have to see, because there's obviously glaring weaknesses in the Ryze's early game.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think a lot of it had to do with the man you see in the top lane right now there. It's Yankos setting up for potentially another gank. Huni, will he be baited once again?
Use his flash.
He's going to start backing.
Might be.
Oh.
No wards, Reckless Glory.
He doesn't see it.
He pinged it. I think he's aware.
Okay, yeah, now he's playing safe. Fool me once, fool me twice, three times, nah.
Where is he gonna go? Rainover has been continuously hovering around mid lane, so should Yankos have showed, he would have revealed himself to Rainover, and he's not really gonna gank bot lane because Mephiles is playing about as far back as you can on Ezreal without dropping too much CS. 10 CS difference in the bottom lane. The game is slowed down. We said earlier, 2,000 gold ahead relative to the state of the game at that point was a lot. Now approaching the 12-minute mark, 1,000 gold. That's overcomeable. So Fnatic calling their way back into this game.
Yeah, and you know, this is a mark of a great team, being able to pull these things back to the place they needed to be as Febiven gets knocked back to the place Rockat wanted him to be. Nuke Duck spending his flash, but Febiven uses one of his own on top of the cleanse to make an escape.
While the Equilibrium Strike did not stun Febiven, the cleanse was essential to get rid of the slow or Vander's Band would have landed. Managed to get to the wall in time and flash over. No flash this time, but they're going aggressive on Steve.
They are. Rainover's going to take some damage, and Twisted Advance won't be enough to stop him. Hooney, after that start, picks up a killing spree.
3-2-1 on Hooney. Who would have known that he had such a horrible start to the game, because he's looking dominant yet again in the top lane. How do you keep this man down?
I don't think you can, Greppo. They tried. Rockat really tried here, but he has started on a roll now. And meanwhile, let's check in down bottom where Rockat are looking to make an advantage play. But Fnatic are pinging it.
They tried to kill him. They got close, but Hooney was the boy who lived. Hooney Potter.
This time
with
around.
With those glasses, that's what inspired me, obviously.
That was a good one. I can give you that.
8 out of 8. Anyways, Yanko's
posing great mate.
In the bot lane. Mystic Shot's coming in, so Reckless is constantly trying to sniff out that gank because he can check for that brush, and that's what I said earlier. They're gonna... Fnatic's been so good at finding Yankos. If he's bottom, they're checking the brushes. If he's not shown there, they know he's not bottom, so he must be top because he hasn't been paying attention to mid lane at all, barring that one gank where Febiven flashed out, and Hooney...
He knows he can take this right into the mini waves too, so Steve's throwing down the Maelstrom right now, but I don't think he's going anywhere. He zooms on in to find Hooney, but his health bar is already melted, and you're not going anywhere. Get in the rune prison. Hooney's still chunking him down. Finally takes a little bit more damage, but an auto attack will do it again. 4-2 on the rise now.
And I think that fan had exactly the same expression as I did just now. What the hell just happened? He said, fool me once, fool me twice. But Hooney just fooled Steve 3 times in a row. 4-2-1 right now. He does pick up the catalyst. Bold move. He went for the damage component first. He said, either I'm going to kill you right now or I'm done in this game. And it paid off. And with the snowball from that one kill, Hooney, that's all you need. Give him one kill and he gets going. Now finishes the Rod of Ages. 40 minutes in. That's enough. Stun on Febiven.
Stun on Febiven indeed. But he's getting some help from Rainover. And there are the transcendent plays. Jankos comes in, knocks him back. And before the Emperor's Divide can finish, Vander has picked him up. Rockat grab one in the middle. They look to start pushing down the line. And they sent Woolite up top to defend the wave.
Yeah, they can't shut Hooney down anymore, so they're aiming their target at Febiven. Get him down, but there's no objective tied to this kill, so essentially team straight 1-1. And Hooney, if there's one target you want to get going on Fnatic's side, it is Ryze. Extremely potent. I can't stress this enough. Late game Ryze does incredible amounts of damage, and the way it's looking, he already does decent amount of damage.
Uh-oh,
look at
Vander. Yeah, right through the black shield, burned down his Yellow Star, picks up the kill, the depth charge. You can't flash away from that Woolite. Yellow Star still lumbering forward, gonna get slowed down for just a minute, but they still pick up another.
So black shield blocks magic damage, but not as much as Hooney's dealing right now. They need about 25 black shields, I think, to survive this burst.
Yeah, his power level is rapidly approaching 9001, I would say. Right now, Hooney gets turned around under the tower, but can he deal with Yankos and Woolite? He turns his attention to Woolite as the tower goes down. Don't think he'll live through this one, Greppo. Shut down by Woolite, but they needed two to do it.
Yeah, this shutdown might very well be incredibly important for this game. Gold is even. Aggression on Nuke Duck. Reckless is here too.
Yep, Reckless is here as well. In come the Sand Soldiers in the True Shot Barrage. Reckless with a nice 1-2. Picks that one up. Dragon's on the board. Fnatic, though, they're interested in towers.
And this is a smart kill because they can transition this into an objective. There's no more wave clear on this tower, and this will open up the map. And Fnatic plays so much better once the map starts opening up because their resource management is fantastic.
Fantastic indeed. Now it's time to start picking off the dragon. Rockat cannot respond to this as well. And what the hell is happening this game? It started so well for Rockat, but now they find themselves down 1,000 gold, down 2 towers. The dragons have evened out. What's going on, Greppo?
Fnatic proving why they're the number one team in the European LCS last split, and very likely the number one LCS team this split as well. Good reaction. It takes a good team to snowball a lead, but it takes a great team to come back from a 2,000 gold deficit, somehow call your way back into the game, And by the 17 minute mark, get ahead back in gold. They swung the gold, 3,000 gold in a period of maybe 12 to 15 minutes. And that's incredibly impressive.
And a lot of that gold sitting on Huni right now. For a top laner, he's been involved in 6 of those 7 kills Fnatic have. A bunch of them have been solo kills on Steve, too. It's really crazy how much these two have bashed at each other. There's no more wet noodle up there. It's a death match.
Death match indeed. So bad indeed that they have had to send 2 people to just deal with Huni. Wuhan and Vander going top, even though the bot lane tower hasn't been taken down yet. Steve should be able to at least stop Reckless from taking his tower, but Reckless will be able to push up. No more rotation mid lane possible, unless it's just change guard with Febivan to send him top potentially. Yellowstar doing the same, helping out his buddy Huni a bit. A lot of pressure on the top lane. This will be a crucial point in the game. They need to get a kill on Huni and take this tower because Rocket's comp is incredibly bad at sieging. So they need to keep the flow going. They need to get a kill, get a tower somehow.
Both of them are trying to bait each other out here, but Yellowstar and Huni are the ones who have to show face to stop this tower push. Woolite, Vander, the Dark Binding splits the uprights right there as Rainover now looking to dive on the bottom side. Reckless pecking away at the tower. Steve can't finish it up. Twisted advance in. They're going to finish the tower, and now they're looking for Steve. He just got himself baited, but he dodges out from the True Shot Barrage. Rainover flashes forward. Ezreal comes in as well. Reckless really wants to pick this one up, and he'll get it. Off to a good start on the Ezreal.
So Steve is off the grid, and that's fantastic for the top lane part of Fnatic, because for the next 22 seconds, Steve can't TP in and make this 4-man dive, or 3-man dive rather, a 4-man dive, and that's impressive.
Yes, it is.
Huni, that was a fantastic
he's, bind by Mather. Yep, just gonna get absolutely locked up by all the CC Rocket have, but meanwhile, while they take him down and take a tower, Fnatic are pretty busy on the bottom side, so they'll trade a first tier for a second. Fnatic's pretty happy with that.
Yeah, Fnatic is so good at capitalizing off kills. I've said this before, you want to tie an objective to your kill. Rocket does it by killing Huni and taking 1 tower. Fnatic does it better by killing Steve and taking 2 towers.
Anything they can do? Well, Fnatic can come right back and do it better. So, Yellowstar left alone to clear the wave as the rest of Rocket are backing away. Let's take stock of where we are in the game. 19 minutes have just hit the board. Slight gold lead for Fnatic after that start, but they've got themselves 4 towers to the one of Rocket. They've evened up the dragons as well.
And they have the scaling advantage on their side. Super predictable composition on the side of Rocket due to the fact that they're all so short range. They will need a flank from Maokai Ratchet's Glory. They will need to go in guns blazing, immediately engage and never leave the fight unless they kill everybody, because otherwise Fnatic will just kite them all day, turn around with Huni, with those snares, with that range skill shot on his Q right now, and Evelynn just slowing him down. Worst case, if they get engaged on too hard, we have the Emperor's Divide that can be used defensively. So if Rocket goes in, either Fnatic dies or they do, because there's no escape plan almost.
No, it doesn't seem like they're really able to get out of a situation once they've committed to it. They've really been using a lot of that stuff, even that they have defensively, in an offensive manner. Vander goes in, but he finds Yellowstar in his way and has to Black Shield himself to avoid the dredge line, the extra bit of the dredge line, rather. And now Fnatic in a fantastic position, gathering more vision for themselves around the map, easily just pushing the waves down bottom. Reckless is having a field day. He is perfectly happy with the game is playing out.
Yeah, and he's not even... He's taking his time pushing this wave out. If you see it, like what's happening right here, he could do this much quicker, but Fnatic's all right with this game going slow. As I said before, very low siege potential on Rocket's side. Very hard for them to find an opening. Fnatic's been playing safe right now. They have the scaling on their side, so all Rocket can do is find a pick somewhere. But even if they do, they're so far away from the towers that they can't really tie an objective into it. And that's why Reckless is taking his sweet time on that bot lane. Maybe even freezing that lane for a bit. Usually I'm against freeze, but I understand why. Rocket will have to answer. If some member, a key carry, is busy on the bot lane just fighting minions, you will have to use that and cross map and try to take somebody down on the other side of the map. But Rocket is starved for vision, and they have a hard time doing this.
Yep, starved for a couple of things. Steve was actually eyeballing the Gromp just to get a little bit more extra XP for himself now. 3 members of Rocket, though, they're stacking on the bottom side. Flash and ult on the Huni. He's going to not be stunned up, though. The Dark Binding doesn't connect. Teleports a flying. Yellowstar comes in. Woolite is going to be the one shut down as Yellowstar picks it up. Huni still focused down. He'll finally fall. Emperor's Divide will push Rocket back into the tower as Steve gets poked down by the Sand Soldiers. In comes Rainover. Flash for flash. Yellowstar for Nuke Duck. Nuke Duck on the run with the Transcendent Blades. True Shot Barrage will soften up Yankos yet again. And now Nuke Duck
being poked just a little bit more. Febiven's not done yet, however.
Yeah, he has backup from Rainover coming in right here. Binding misses, and they kill Huni, but at what cost? Fnatic, good reaction, defending the dive. Febiven pushing the enemy back under his tower. And Fnatic might even capitalize on this with a Baron because everybody got poked so low. Teleport was used. All ultimates used. Fnatic in prime control of this game. They're in a driver's seat right now.
Yep, they got a teleport for Huni too as he's just come back off cooldown. They know Jankos and Vander Smite's are prowling around. Up. It's not quite there though. Can he get in time? No, he's being chased away. Reckless helps him get out of town. And Rainover secures the Baron. Fnatic grab one at 22.
And this is the nail in the coffin for Rocket. 4,200 gold behind right now. And let's see that again. They want Huni, but he barely manages to flash before that body slam connects. Double knockup from the Nautilus ulti. Wulite's going down because he gets CC'd. Steve comes in, but it's too late. Huni's done his job. He survived for so long, taking one guy out. Look at Steve, has to walk all around that wall. Febiven can play in the safety of his soldiers. Nuketuck will have to flash right here. Yellow starts chasing him. And Fnatic's putting Rocket on the back foot, and we said this, if they commit for a play, if they commit for a dive, they're gonna be losses. Either they kill Fnatic, or they're gonna bleed heavily, so heavy that they lost the Baron.
Yeah, they lost the Baron. They've been down in the lead, but it gets extended even further. Just about 4,000 for Fnatic. As we saw, they took a dragon on top of all that in the craziness while a replay was rolling out. So Fnatic, as you said, they're in the driver's seat, and they're not letting go of the wheel anytime soon.
Oh, they're not. What's next for Fnatic? Let's take a look. They have a 4,000, 5,000 gold lead. They have four towers already. They have the Baron buff. They're spreading out, and I love it when teams spread out with Baron because all lanes getting those minion buffs is so crucial, especially if your team that plays calculated, I'm not going to call it safe, but plays calculated as well as Fnatic. They always have this buddy system going on. If Yellowstar goes for Vision, he has Rainover with him. If Rainover goes to kill a pink ward, Yellowstar's lurking at the side. Rocket's looking for a pick though.
They found Yellowstar. Not the ideal target, but Rainover's there. Vander throws down the Soul Shackles, but it's Wulite who's getting chunked. Yellowstar tries to dredge away, but he gets shut down by Jankos. Wulite now on the run. Rainover, they just don't have enough damage, and Huni gets stopped up by the explosive cast. Rocket, they might have just barely managed to find it as Jankos narrowly gets out. Febiven, though, comes in with a massive ultimate, and he looks for Steve. The soldiers are flying.
Here's
he
Reckless.
Picks him up. Reckless comes in. Double kill, however, as Nuketuck picks it up and answer. Reckless, he's going down as well, and Rocket secure the ace.
And just as I was complimenting Fnatic on playing so safe, they take it one step too far. Beautiful reaction from Rocket. This is exactly what they had to do. If somebody's about to 1v1 you, stop it before it goes into the final stage because it will be too late. Watch this face check. Yes, Yellowstar is there. Yes, he has his buddy Rainover, but it's too little. If you watch your minimap, look where Reckless is. Look how far he has to walk. Huni barely can't reach anybody over the wall. He's doing double golems, tries to get people over the wall right now, but Rainover's already dead. And Wulite in these one by one by one fight, the Urgot passive is essential. Minus 15% damage on your carry. That's massive, especially when you do AoE damage. He gets it on Huni, he gets it on Febiven, takes him down. Now he gets it on Reckless. He barely takes down Wulite. Watch this duel. If Reckless didn't have that passive, good chance that Wulite could have dropped there, especially with the red buff at the end. Look how low it is. Good use of that Urgot passive, and that's exactly the way Rocket wants to fight. These close range fights where they don't get punished for being low range, but one by one by one, every time you take one down, next, Fnatic. They played into Rocket's hand there, and I'm dazzled that Rocket managed to get out of there, and it's a really good game read to go for that pick because it's absolutely essential. They had to do that, or they were about to get locked in, pinned down, and had to surrender.
And with that, they were able to cut down the game lead that Fnatic had established down to only about 3,000 gold, but Rocket, one good play. Let's see if they can chain several more together. Vander roving through the jungle. Find Yellowstar with a ward as the latter was placing one behind the pit. Rocket feeling a little bit more confident, looking to peck away at this bottom tower. See if they can grab a little bit more gold in their pockets.
And Steve with half the deaths off his team so far on the tank. So we see incredible scorelines, 2-0-10 on the Jankos. We see 2-1-6 on Vander. So it's good to an extent because Rocket will feel confident. They won't feel that they're that far behind because every member except Steve will feel that they have a decent stat line. They're strong enough to take these fights, and Steve, he's a tank, so he doesn't mind dying a couple times, but they're bleeding towers. Look at Fnatic sieging in the mid lane. They're doing what Rocket can't do in a fight.
Febiven, though, is tanking under tower as he slides and glides around. Nuketuck not quite going down. They can't finish him. Febiven jumped on by Steve. In for the flank around the side. They throw the exhaust down as Wulite is able to secure the kill onto Huni. Nuketuck can't really get involved in this fight. Or can he? He goes in the back. There's a double kill for Steve. Looking for Rainover. Polishing him off. That is going to be an ace for none. Rocket big fight, big win for them.
Incredible fight by Rocket. Nuketuk barely survives that fight on about 10% of speed, doesn't leave, goes back into the backline, and that flash stun on Reckless. Absolutely fantastic play. Rocket not getting kited by Fnatic because they're coming from the front, the back, the left, the right. Steve teleported in Febuzz's back just when he thought he was safe. Twisted advance to take him out, and Rocket, phenomenal comeback in this game. I can't stress this enough. This is very, very impressive.
Yep, they had a great start. Not so great of a mid game, but now they're starting to get ahead again. Not one, but two towers secured in the mid lane. Nuketuk looks to push a wave in the bottom. We'll be able to back away from that one. Dragon's coming up in another minute, but let's look at that fight again.
Fnatic Fevevin gets knocked back into the tower, takes a lot of damage, dashes out. We'll see Steve finish him up later, but let's keep our eyes on Nuketuk. He goes out on 10% in the main fight. Reckless can't really pick up a kill. Steve is still tanky. He died 7 times. Meanwhile, Urgot, Woolite rather, finished up Huni in the back, and this flash stun on Reckless is just what I want to stress again. Really solid play. Rocket's fanning out, but they're contracting again just when they need to play as a team, as the giant death ball machine that they are, and they win this fight convincingly. And honestly, I'm very, very surprised that they managed to come back into the game.
Absolutely. And, you know, Steve, I think really demonstrating, just like last game, how valuable this Maokai pick is. He's 6-7-7. That's actually a fairly pretty good score for your tank line, and we saw the same thing happen last time around. He just simply can't be killed, but he's doing a serious amount of damage when he finally pops that Vengeful Maelstrom, just enough to be able to polish people off. So now, with half a minute left, Rocket are in prime position to contest a Dragon. Fnatic have to be careful. They're a little on the back foot now. The towers have evened out. I mean, this game, this is about as even as it really gets, considering how crazy back and forth it's been.
Yeah, fantastic game so far. And Steve, we said it in champs, like, if he falls behind, might have to wait a little bit here. Dredgeline comes out, barely misses. Go back to my point. If Steve falls behind, but gets the Maokai, he can come back and Twisted advance in.
Yes, he can. Finds Huni on that one, who just doesn't quite have enough. They don't quite have enough to take him down, but Woolite gets jumped in on. He's gonna spend his ultimate. Can he waddle away fast enough? No, the crab walk is not strong enough. Fnatic are looking to pick off even more as Reckless takes down Steve. 2-for-none so far, running forward, Nuketuk dashing onto the blue buff, and Fnatic have come back again.
Yeah, and you saw the hesitation on Rocket's sides. Are we gonna fight these guys? I can engage. Is it a good idea? I don't know. And it wasn't a good idea. Why? Because they all came from the same angle, and you can't do that against this Fnatic lineup. Huni will immediately hit all his skill shots. If you're walking straight to him, he will snare you. You have the Emperor's Divide coming. You will get kited. And every fight so far, Rocket has won when they either surprised Fnatic with their position or came from multiple angles, multiple sides, flanks. They didn't have that for this fight. They hesitated, rightfully so. Quite the mistake going in there, but this game has been back and forth, and Rocket by no means are they out of this game. I'm done counting out Rocket. I will not count out Rocket anymore until that Nexus explodes.
We asked the question at the beginning, like, can they get back to the form that they really haven't had since last year? And I feel like they're giving Fnatic
a run for their money.
A serious run for their money. With all of that, Fnatic, since they win the fight, they get the spoils, they secure the Baron, but Rocket grab a Dragon to even that particular score. They did not rest on that. They didn't go back to base and lick their wounds. They took advantage of a moment when they knew Fnatic would be elsewhere on the map. Now they just have to defend this Baron wave for a few more minutes.
Yeah, still two more item slots to go on Huni's Rise, so time definitely still speaks in Fnatic's favor. Once that Rise hits his critical mass, that 5-item Rise plus Boots, it's gonna be crucial. Yes, he's filled that with the Wisp, but it's not enough, just some CDR, I believe, if I'm correct. Double check that. Yep. No, movement speed on that Wisp.
He wants
used
to
it with Forbidden Idol. Happens to the best of us.
Yes, it does. Now, Fnatic were able to peck away at that tower in the mid. They do secure that one through Jankos roaming around.
Flanking, this is good. You want to have at least one guy on the side to disrupt that giant kiting machine that Fnatic is, and they have to commit for that tower. The Spirit inwards. No more flanking from Jankos. They need him on wave clear duty. Now, I really like the addition of the base gates, the void gates that right added a while ago, because at least now you have an opportunity to flank in between your lanes. If they weren't there, Fnatic would have a lot easier time rotating between mid and bot. But now they have to be careful for Binds over the wall. Barely hitting.
Connects.
But look at the tower. It's dropping lower and lower.
Very, very low. Fnatic only have to poke it a few more times. They just need a wave or two. Meanwhile, Huni's still haranguing the bot side. Rocket are stretched a little bit thin. They don't have to worry about that third lane up in the top. Still got a tower there, but Huni's just letting those minions push with the Baron Empowerment on them. Nuketuk, he's kind of torn between things. Now he's finally able to secure them off as Huni moved out of range, so the Baron Empowerment wasn't happening. Jankos chased away by the Azir soldiers. back on wave clear duty.
A lot of respect Fnatic. From Fnatic, though.
Yeah, they are not going to dive into a situation they know that they may not have 100% chance of winning here. So they'll play it out as safely as they can. Rocket not keen to let them inside their base after the performance they've managed to put up this game. It would be a shame, but Huni still on the spot side.
Bottom, relatively low on mana, has a lot of mana in his pool, but if a fight breaks out, it's very likely that Huni will just go oom immediately. So if Rocket recognizes this, they might go for a play.
Right, indeed. The question is, do they right now? Instead, they're going
drops,
to give up the tower.
Not so sure. Look at Huni's mana pool on the top left corner of your screen right now. He wants a blue buff, but he can't find it. There's a pink ward on the map. Doesn't even find it, goes for the Grump instead, but yeah, completely out of mana, has the base. And gives Rocket some breathing room.
Yeah, I'll give him a little bit of time. So with that Baron buff, Fnatic were able to secure two towers. That's about it. Not the worst thing for Team Rocket. Right?
As far as Baron buffs go, I think Fnatic will be okay with it, and Rocket will be very happy with it. Defending your inhibitor is absolutely crucial, especially if you're playing this low range, very poor siege comp, where you want at least be able to pressure out some waves to rotate around the map. Very slow stage of the game right now. I think teams are looking for more dragons, more barons. Lure somebody into a trap. You don't want to be the team that makes the mistake right now, because you're at the stage of the game 33 minutes in where either side can win a fight convincingly if it starts on the wrong foot, and the consequences are very, very destructive.
Yeah, we say the game is settled, but I mean, really, it's like a massive chemical reaction at this point. There's been so much action on both sides. It's been tilting the scales in either team's favor that the next fight could very well determine the game.
It could very well indeed. What's going to happen now? I'm quite curious. Is Fnatic going to span out a bit? Just try and push out the lanes, push in Rocket on all sides. Gonna have to be careful for a pick in reaction. Is Rocket just gonna wait for a dragon? It's still 1 minute 50 seconds. Reckless clearing his wave on the bottom. Rocket is scared a bit. They always have to move in numbers or move where they have vision. Now they see Huni in the top lane. He has teleport though. Nuke Tuck a little bold here. Let's not forget Irelia in the mid to late game can assassinate AD carry incredibly quick. And Jankos, he wants that red buff.
Yes, but so does Rainover or Reckless as they have chased Rocket out of their own jungle. Reckless will be able to secure that one. And Rocket can't really get much for their efforts here. They have to send Steve top, of course, to defend this wave that Huni had pushed out. So it seems like we've just got ourselves a little bit of back and forth.
Good old standoff. With the advantage slightly to Fnatic in terms of wave clear, but Rocket is so dangerous if they catch you out. And Fnatic doesn't have the deep vision to support bold minion wave pushes. So instead of pushing a wave in and pressuring it further like here, they'll just push it to Rocket's side of the map. Rocket cleans it, albeit a slightly slower, and then it neutralizes again until the next waves hit. But Fnatic always has the first move, but they have to be careful. They're very scared of moving past this river. You've seen this. Reckless is in the bottom, can't really commit too much. Rocket is fine playing this low tempo game right now. They're just looking for that crucial pick, that one mistake that Fnatic makes where Rocket can open up the flanks and engage. Remember, Woolite has Flash, has that hyperkinetic position reverser. Only one target from Fnatic needs to get swapped out. And a whole lot of mayhem in his view. But I believe he got that blue buff, and that's
he's been wanting for a while. It's on his wish list. Finally secures that one up. 10 seconds now on this next dragon. Febivin throws down the Sun Disc. Fnatic are setting up for this. Staggering some backs.
And now Huni will be a lot happier to spend a lot of mana clearing his wave, which in turn adds a lot more pressure. This is a very big blue buff. Can't underestimate this. Gets a lot of more mana regen, spamming it. Speed up a bit.
Dragon started, there's no response here from Rocket. Ping in the middle for Fnatic. They know that Rocket are going to try to play the game of chicken, so they're
Rocket dragon. Wants to raid to the top tower here. That's, you saw the pings right there. If people commit for a dragon, usually, again, you go for that cost map. But just a little bit too late. We might see a fight here, though.
We might. There's a big minion wave at Rocket's back.
Rainover's looking for a flank.
All five members here, though. Rocket, they know something's up.
Do up on them as they do onto you.
Oh, Rainover finds Nuke Duck, starting things off, sends down the challenging smite, and that'll be it.
If Rocket kept stayed group on that lane, Rainover flank could have been really crucial, because it would start a fight where, again, Rocket would be in front of Fnatic and have no flank potential themselves. So not only does he flank Rocket, he also spots potential flanks from Rocket's side. So good move by Rainover. Has to be careful, though. If he gets caught out, he drops, then suddenly Fnatic's without a tank. Yeah, Yellowstar, he can soak up some damage, but wouldn't call him a tank too much.
No.
Tanky.
Appropriate. Yes.
Tanky, but not a tank.
Steve has been really on side lane duty for the most part of the last 5 minutes. He's really not done much else than just absorb farm here. Sitting on that teleport, still has that available if action does commence. Looks like it might, as Fnatic trying to push their luck and push their movements through the jungle of Rockat.
Yeah, in terms of action, we can't complain. 33 kills on the board here in 37 minutes. Almost a kill every minute.
Just like the last couple of minutes. Jankos might add to that. Nope. He's going to dash away.
Game's slowing down here. Fnatic wants that inhibitor. Baron is live, so if they can push up and put enough pressure and lock Rocket in their base to the point where their wards expire, they can move back to the Baron area. The reason Fnatic's not baiting the Baron is because Rocket managed to get the crab. They're at the Baron area, if you see that little dot on your minimap. That's why Fnatic's opting to put some pressure on the inhibitor safely. If they can get it, nice. If they can't, they'll eventually just back up to the Baron.
At this point, Rocket, they're in a little bit of a desperate scramble to try and defend, so they have to start.
They got Hooney! In comes Steve, they find Hooney, but he flashes away. Steve, push back, Emperor's Divine, True Shot, Barrage. The combo is real, as Nuketuck now being fired down. Double kill over to Reckless, and the inhibitor still being poked away as Reckless pokes the rest of the team away. They found that. What will they go from here?
And this is why you need flanks. If Hooney can flash out defensively and there's nobody on his side or in his back to punish him, for that flash, then he can go back into the game, slowly move up forward, safely, calculated, and that's the way Fnatic wants to play. You need that flank potential. If Rocket all goes for the front door, he'll just get pushed back by Emperor's Divide, and that's exactly what Fnatic did. Fevevin still has his cleanse, Hooney still has his teleport, Inhibitor is down, Baron is down. Looking for a...
Jankos and Vander, Drex lined in. They're going to send it out. Fabivin, Rainover, Reckless all knocked apart. And that explosive cast may very well have saved Rocket this game, but maybe not enough.
Moonlight's
found. Hyperkinetic position reverse, crab walk away. Can he make it to the base gate? The race is on, and I don't think he's going anywhere. Hooney locks him up and takes him down.
With the improved recall from Baron, only takes 4 seconds. Hooney goes to the base, pops his home guards, teleports back in, finds a kill on Woolite. I think they wanted to join that wave on the top lane, but it'll be a little bit too late. Sending Hooney bottom to clear out that wave. And they want to go into a bit of a 4-1, maybe 1-3-1 here to close out the game. This Baron buff will facilitate that. Whereas before they had to be slow and passive to get that inhibitor, they have the one in the mid lane down. Switch that again. Yeah, they go on Jankos. Notice the Black Shield switch to Vander. Trying to see both of them. White comes in and Hooney, watch him. He's based on the pit because he couldn't flash over the wall. Remember, he used his flash earlier. Teleports in home guards. Good swap by White. Outranges here. Forces Rain over to pop his ulti, I believe. Not quite sure. And then they close the gap. Kill White. Good return kill, but
yeah.
Kind of stops the momentum. You know, you spend about 34, 40 seconds getting that kill. Then you base. Then you come back and White is back alive. Yes, it's nice, but you just lost about a minute on your Baron buff. But it could have been more.
I don't think they're too worried, though, considering how much they're chunking these towers
down. I don't think they are.
Now.
Could have been 2 or 3 kills and just instant finish the game. So good move by Fnatic.
Yep.
Hooney in the middle. 4 people on the top lane.
Hooney's in the base. He's looking to chase them down as Steve picks up Fevevin. Fnatic not perturbed by this one. Reckless picking up a kill onto Willite now. Meanwhile, look back to Hooney as he's 2v1ing. Nuketuck going down right now. So is Hooney. Jankos picks him up, but he still slays Nuketuck in the process. Steve trying to get all in everybody's business, but Reckless will take him down. The gates are open. Fnatic is on the Nexus turrets as the super minions take down one. They'll polish off another. The shred they've got is just so real right now. Jankos and Vander trying desperately to defend.
What an incredible game. Back and forth. Rocket ahead. Fnatic back in the game. Rocket back ahead. And Fnatic, they close it out with a 3-0 so far.
3-0 on the board. But that was the hardest they have been tested. And you look at their faces right now.
They're not happy.
They're not happy with that.
Some smiles coming out.
Relieved, I think, would probably be the best way to say.
I think relieved is definitely what they are right here. They struggled, but good composure under that stress. Have to hand it to them.
At the end of the day, Fnatic is still the golden boys.
Got the win.
You know, is a way to start. But as they move over to the other side of the board, Rocket, what a hell of a fight they gave them.
And I'm just very impressed by how they came back into this game. Yes, they gave away their lead. Wasn't so impressed with that. But then I had almost written them off, and they came back into this game, got back on top, and yeah, really good beat. I said this before, 1-3-1, you have to shut it down before it manifests itself in the final stage, because it'll be impossible, because if you commit to one side, the two other sides will punish you, and that's why it's such a good strategy if you can pull it off. And we saw why Giants didn't do it earlier, because it's so risky, because if you overextend at one point, Fnatic did. They had their buddy system going out. Rainover was there with Yellowstar together, but it wasn't enough. Huni was caught over the wall. Good capitalization from Rocket, and both teams can be proud here. Both teams played well, but everybody's almost beating everybody. But in the end,
Fnatic still wins.
Fnatic still wins.
Trend is proven true yet again today, Crepo. So Fnatic, definitely, I would say some things to look at for that game. A lot of it comes down to Rocket just making good plays. But still, you know, even the top team in Europe, they're not immune to making mistakes, and that's what was proved here today.
Yeah, they noticed the weakness in Huni's Ryze, in mobile, got his flash. I really want to go back to that first gank as well, the flash twisted advance from Steve, forced Huni's flash, and he still died, and that's so important. If you can get a kill and blow a summoner, because then you can return and do it over and over and over again in the next 4 to 5 minutes to keep punishing, keep snowballing that. But then Huni, at one point, he just... What happened? How do you get a kill when you're 0-2 behind? Is Ryze that good? I'm really looking forward to see more of this Ryze coming out later in the game. Have teams prepared? Have they said, nobody's going to play it? Are people going to play it? Because the pick and ban metagame is already so, not necessarily complex, but there's a lot of good picks and a lot of bans out there that you already kind of have to do. If you have to add Ryze into that equation, are you ready for that?
Yeah, I mean, and that's the thing. I don't think really either team was prepared for exactly how this one shaped up, but I definitely don't think Rockout was expecting the Ryze. You could see the hesitation in picking up the Maokai at the end of it all. But you take a look at the way the comps were laid out, as we saw in the beginning of the game. Fnatic definitely played that out well, but in the very beginning, they didn't seem to have quite a grasp on it, and that's the danger with experimenting.
Yeah, and the compositions tell the story of the game. We see how short-ranged Rockout's side is. Gragas, Maokai. When Urgot's the longest like range on your team, then you're very all-in focused, and then you have to flank. You have to flank, and we saw it work. Or you have to surprise Fnatic, but eventually Fnatic learned from their mistakes. They only kept Rocket at bay. They kept him in front of them. Mm-hmm. Have that extra wall coming in from the Azir, kite backwards. Defensive flash will work if you're not getting flanked. And Rocket, they ran out of steam. The pain train finally stopped for them,
yeah,
and it wasn't enough.
And not only that, too, I feel like a lot of what Rocket picked for was maybe a little bit more lanes, and the lanes didn't matter as much after a while. The mid lane, we wanted to take a look at that one,
yeah.
The Aurelia matchup. Nuke Duck, he did fairly well in the lane, but in the fights, it didn't really come together with the rest of their comp. They did want to run an all-in, but he wasn't as much of a factor as his teammates.
But he added a lot of pressure, and this is one of the few times we've seen Nuke Duck really come forward. I was wondering, is he going to put enough pressure? And he didn't have any jungle help, because Jankas was always on the top lane, rightfully where he should be. Not pointing any fingers here. He was right
and not
to
that
top.
He needed it in lane. Either.
And then Nuke Duck held his own, had the Aurelia, had a couple good fights. Remember that one fight where he flashed in from the side? And you know, I imagine analysts
that was
not
going to
highlight too many
play.
Replays here, guys. But he flashed in, got that Equilibrium Strike, stunning onto Reckless, and he turned around a lot of these fights. So Rocket. They impressed me, but it's such a complex composition to play, so short range, so one could argue not one dimensional, but too many dimensions to play it out right, because once you're locked in front of Fnatic, again, they can punish you over and over. I was stalling a little bit here for a couple of the Fnatic members that just passed us heading to the analyst test.
There were some super crazy tussles this game. I mean, even in the early game when you had like that one person coming in, another person coming in, and it ends up being like an even trade at the end of the day. I mean, that was one of the wackiest starts to a game in Europe I think we've had in a while. And we've had the Unicorns versus Fnatic already.
Yeah, that's actually a very good point you make there. That's where you buy into the chaos too much. That was a fight in the early game where Rocket could have backed out. They were already saved, but Steve's teleport was channeling, and instead of telling him, no, Steve, just cancel it, we'll go later, they went in, and they gave Huni that crucial kill, and they gave Fnatic a little bit more tempo. They got extra gold. Fnatic closed the gap and kind of started clawing back there. And yeah, it's so hard to not buy into that chaos.
Yeah, it is hard not to buy into that chaos, but even though they did it a little bit, Fnatic still came out with a big W. So for now, we're going to send...